In lesson number 6, retirement, death of a partner, today we will start question number 13, page number 270. See, now what they have given, LB and W are the partners of a firm sharing profit and losses in the ratio 2:2:1. So here first of all we will write down that is 2:2:1, that is equals to 5. Fine. Then they have given the balance sheet as under. So this is your balance sheet. What they have told you, W retired on 1/4/2016. Terms of retirement were decided as under. See, adjustments are given 6. Okay, prepare necessary account and balance sheet of the new firm. So see here, who is retiring? W is retiring. Fine. L, B and W. So W is your last partner. So your star, here we will put the star. See, this is the last partner. So here we will put the box. Okay. So W share is 1/5. Then what you'll do here, so here we will write down by balance brought down, here we will write down 2 balance carried down, and see W is retiring, so here put a dash in W, and in your balance sheet go your capital. See, as W is retiring, now there will be capital of only L and B. Fine. And here in cash also we will write down, that is 2 balance brought down. Okay, so our format is ready. Now we will start our first adjustment. See what they have given. Market value of building is 50,000. See, the value for building is what they have given. 50,000 is the market value for building. So on asset side, we will write down, that is building 50,000. Okay. Then what is there? In our old balance sheet, we will go, the value for building was 37,000 and now it is 50,000. So what is the difference? See, 50,000 minus 37,000. Okay, so 30, previously it was 37,000, now it is 50,000. So it is increasing by 13,000. As it is increasing by 13,000, 13,000 is our profit. So that will be recorded your revaluation account by building account, that is 13,000. Fine, this is our profit. Then see the next adjustment, what they have given. Book value of stock is 10% more than its cost. Stock is to be recorded at its cost. Fine. So your 10% more than is word is there. Okay, so first we'll go to working note. See here, stock, our first working note. Okay, they have told more than. Fine. So here, what is the value for stock? It is 5500. So here 5500, I have told you, whenever more than or less than is there, in the numerator there will be always 100, whether it is more than or whether it is less than. Now what they have told you here, 10% more than. Okay, so in 100 you will add 10%, so you'll get 110. Fine. So now we'll do this calculation. 5500 into 100 divided by 110. What you are getting? 5000. So your, now your new value for stock is rupees 5000. Okay, this is your new value for stock. Okay, so here we will write down our stock, that is 5000. So see, previously it was 5500 and now it is 5000. So it is been reduced by 500. As it is reduced, so it is loss. So your two stock account, that is 500. Clear? Then see, third adjustment. Personal expenses of W of rupees 500 was debited to P&L account. See, they, at that time it was debited to P&L account. So right now what you will do, you will credit, okay, and P&L account. So previously it was debited, okay. So personal expense of W, it was debited to P&L account. Now but there is what? Revaluation account. Okay, so here they have mentioned it is debited. So here put, you'll put on your credit side in revaluation. That is, revaluation is also known as profit and loss adjustment. So the second effect will come here. That is, by personal expense of W account, that is 500. See, now this is the personal expense of W. So personal expense will become drawing for him. So here in partner's capital, you will write down, that is two drawings account, that is in W you will go and you will write down 500. Fine. Then see the next adjustment. Goodwill of the firm is valued at 80,000. Okay. So see, here we will write down second, that is
goodwill of firm rupees, they mentioned it is 80,000. So here 80,000 from this firm's goodwill, you will find out W's share of goodwill. So W's share of goodwill is equals to 80,000 multiply by, see what was W share, 1/5. So here 1/5. So when you do this calculation, 80,000 into 1 is 80,000 only, and divided by 5. So here you are getting that is rupees 16,000. Okay, now for this you have to pass the journal entry. So see the rough format of journal entry we will prepare here. Okay, so here the partner who is retiring will be always credited. Credit what goes out, like that you have to remember. So 2W's capital account, here you will write down that is 16,000. Fine. Now whose account will be debited? So see in the next they've given L will gain 5/40 and B will gain 3/40 from W's share of profit. So here what is the gain ratio? Gain ratio is 5:3. Fine. So in this ratio we will distribute the amount. So see here the gain ratio is given to you. So the retiring partner is here credited. So the existing partner will be debited. That is L's capital account debited and B's capital account debited. Fine. So now 16,000 will be distributed in the gain ratio. And what is the gain ratio? So 5:3, that is equals to 8. So your gain ratio is equals to 5:3, that is equals to 8. So in this ratio we have to distribute this 16,000. So 16,000 first we will divide by 8. So divide by 8 and then multiple 5 equals to. So here there will be 10,000 and then 3 equals to. Don't press multiple sign. So here it is 6,000. So see both the sides are now tallied, 16,000 and 16,000. Now see you'll give the posting of this. So here by L and by B. So here we will write down by L's capital account, by B's capital account. See as L and B is written, so here in L and B we will put a dash. Okay, and the amount will go to W. So here 10,000 and then 6,000. Fine. Here by N and by B. So here there will be 2W's capital account. As here it is W, so there will be dash in W. So for L amount was how much? 10,000. So here in L column we will write down 10,000 and B's column we will write down 6,000. Clear? Then see next what they have given. Amount due to W is to be paid in cash. Okay, so amount due to W, whatever the amount is there due for W will be paid in cash, and the same amount will be brought in cash by L and B in such a manner that their capital may remain in the new profit and loss sharing ratio in the firm. So this adjustment we will do at the end when you will close the partner's capital account. Okay, at that time I will explain you that adjustment. So right now all the adjustments are over. We will move on to the posting of balance sheet. See, the capital of LB and W is 20,000, 12,500 and 5,000. So you all will write down that is by balance brought down 20,000, then 12,500 and then 5,000. Clear? Next is general reserve. So general reserve is 5,000. It will be distributed among the partner. So here by general reserve account. See here 5,000 and the ratio is 2:2:1. That is also 5. So 2,000, 2,000 and 1,000. No need to do on calculator. So here 2,000, 2,000 and 1,000. Fine. Then see next. Creditors. So as it is write down on liability side, so creditors, the amount is 20,000. Then outstanding expense. So your outstanding expense also, see next item is outstanding expense. So this also we will write down as it is outstanding expense 3,000. Fine. Next is goodwill. See this is old goodwill which will be distributed among the partners. So your two goodwill account. Fine. And 8,000 will be distributed in the ratio that is 2:2:1, that is equals to 5. So 8000 divided by 5, clear? Then into 2 equals 2, so 3200, again 3200 because 2 is there, and then 1 equals 2, so 1600. So this way we have distributed the goodwill among the partner. Next is building, that we have done. Debtors we have not done, so debtors as it is write down 13000. So here debtors 13000, okay. Then stock we have completed, cash that is 2000. So here we will write down cash, but amount we won't write down here, that amount will go here. To balance brought down, that is how much, so it is 2000. Fine. Now the posting of balance sheet is also over, so first we will close our revaluation account. So see here what you'll get. The credit side is greater, 13,500, here it is only 500. So 13,500, this side also 13,500, 500 will be deducted. So the profit is 13,000. So to revaluation profit account, clear? This will be distributed among three partners, that is L, B and W, in the ratio 2:2:1. So again 13,000 divided by 5 multiplied by 2 equals 2, so 5200, again 5200, and then there will be, that is 1 equals 2, so that is 2600. Fine. Now this profit here, it is on two sides, so in the partner's capital it will come on buy side. So buy revaluation profit account, that is 5200, 5200 and 2600, clear? Now see, when you close this partner's capital account, okay, we have to remember that sixth adjustment is still remaining. What they have told you, first amount due to W is to be paid in cash. First we will do only till here, that whatever the amount for W is remaining will be paid in cash. So first we will close W's account. So see here, we will close the partner's capital. First we will be closing only for W. So see, W is how much? First 5000 plus 10000 plus 6000 plus 1000 plus 2600. We are getting 24600. So here we will write down 24600. This side also 24600. Deduct this two amount, that is minus 500 and minus 1600. So what you are getting? 22500. Okay. And what they have told you, see, W is retiring, so we won't record anything here, that is two balance carried down. Okay. The amount will go here, that is the difference will be coming this side, 22500. Here what they have told you, the dues of W is to be paid in cash. See here, it won't go to loan account, W's loan account. Okay. Why? Every time we are putting in W's, or whatever the partner is retiring, we are putting in that. Okay. But here what they have mentioned, that when the partner will retire, it goes to loan account. But here it will be going to, that is cash account. Okay. After his retirement, because the dues are to be paid in cash. Clear? Now your two cash is there, so the entry will come in cash account buy side. So here we will write down buy W's capital account 22500, clear? Then see, now further what they have mentioned, and the same amount will be brought in cash by L and B in such a manner that their capital, now this same amount, see, which same amount? So this 22500, same amount the W will bring, okay, and this same amount will be brought in cash by L and W, but in such a way that their capital may remain in the new profit and loss sharing ratio in the new firm. So see what you will do now here, see, this amount W has to be paid in cash, okay. So 22500, write down here, okay, amount paid to W, that is 22500. Fine, keep it here. Now what you will do, whatever the deduction you are doing, okay, after calculating L's and B's, because they have told that L and B will keep their capital in their new profit and loss sharing ratio, okay. So first you have to find out the amount of capital, okay. Here the amount of capital, how you will obtain? So first deduct L. See, do not write down anything here. Whatever the things come, that as an actual difference you will write down here, okay. Actual difference for L and for B you will write down here, clear? And already you have to write down this amount also, because they have told that this amount also will be brought by L and B in the ratio of, that is new ratio, to maintain this capital, fine. So this you will write down here, then you will find out L and B's actual difference, of which you will do the total. See, I'll show you. So here the amount we will write down first, that is for L, that is 20,000 plus 2,000 plus 5,200. Do not write down the total here, fine. What you will do, deduct this two amount directly on calculator, that is minus 10,000 minus 3,200. So what you are getting, 14,000 you are getting, okay. For that W you will write down 14,000 here. See, that is actual difference, fine. Same way do for B. What is there? 12,500 plus 2,000 plus 5,200. Okay, again do not write down here 19,700. Directly deduct this. So minus 6,000 minus 3,200. Okay, the difference which you are getting, that you will write down here as an actual difference for B. That is 10,500. Okay, so here we will write down 10,500. Now do the total of all these three, clear? So see, 10,500 is already on the screen, plus 14,000 and plus 22,500, because this amount is also, which W is taking in cash, will be paid by L and B, okay, in the ratio. So here they have told that it is coming 47,000. Now this amount you have to maintain in the ratio. Which ratio? So new ratio. So see, we don't have new ratio, so this is to be distributed in new ratio. What is new ratio? We don't know right now. So now we will calculate our new ratio, okay. So that is our third working note, okay. That is new ratio. What will be the formula of new ratio? See, so old ratio plus gain ratio. See, in the sum the gain ratio is mentioned in adjustment number 5, fine. So here we have to use this gain ratio, that is 5 upon 40 and plus 3 upon 40. Do not take 5 is to 3, that is 5 upon 8 and 3 upon 8. Whenever you want to find out the new ratio, whatever is there actually. So see now, new ratio for L and B, okay. So old ratio is what? So old ratio is 2 upon 5. So here 2 upon 5, here also 2 upon 5. Plus and plus. So gain ratio, see, again I'm repeating, do not take 5 is to 3. Whenever you are calculating new ratio, you have to use as it is, that is 5 upon 40 and 3 upon 40. So see here, 5 upon 40 and here 3 upon 40. So see, if we take LCM, okay, or cross multiplication if you want to do, then it will be very big. So we better take LCM. See, 40, 5 in table of 5, where it is coming 40, so 5 8s are, so here 8, so here also it will go 8. So here 40, 8 2s are 16, here the 40 is there, so it is only by 1, multiple by 1, so 5 1s are 5. Again here 40, so here what you will get, 4 2s are, don't do like that, okay. Here 8s are, so here also 8s are, okay, 5 8s are, so 8 2s are 16 again, and plus, that is 5, sorry, not 5, 3, fine, because here 40 is there, so 1s are, and here also 1s are. So here what you will get, that is 16 plus 5, so that is 21 upon 40, and here 16 plus 3 is 19 upon 40. So the new ratio comes, that is 21 is to 19, that is equals to 40, fine. So now in this ratio you will calculate, that is you will distribute this amount. So the ratio is 21 is to 19, that is equals to 40. Now 47,000 you have to distribute in this ratio. So see, 47,000 is there on calculator, divided by 40, multiple, press only one time, and now first you will multiply it by 21. So 21. So it is coming 2, 4, 6, 7, 5. You will write down for the first partner. 2, 4, 6, 7, 5 for L. Clear? And then don't press multiple, only 19 equals to. So that is 22,325. Clear? So why we have taken this 3? Normally we were taking only actual difference of L and B, but they have told that W will, whatever the W is taking will also be given by the same amount will be paid by L and B in their ratio. Okay? So this is also included here. Clear? Now this is your capital. Okay? So this capital, write down here 2, 4, 6, 7, 5, 2, 2, 3, 2, 5. When you will add this 2, again you will get that is 47,000. Clear? Now see. Now this you have obtained with the help of the ratio, not by calculating the difference. Okay? So this you have to maintain. Whenever you have to maintain this, whatever the difference is coming, either the partner will bring the cash or the partner will withdraw the cash. See, if this side it is coming, it means the partner has to bring the cash. If this side is coming, it means the partner has to take away extra cash to maintain this. So now we will find out. So see, now you are 24 plus 10, it is 34, more than 34 up to 37 something, and when you see this side, it is only in 20s, 27. So obviously this side is greater. So we will do the total of this side. So see, 10,000 plus 3,200 plus 24,675. We are getting that is 37,875. So here we will write down 37,875. The bigger total we will write down on both the side. So 37,875. See, here nothing is mentioned that to maintain this, what where the difference is to be transferred. They have only told that you have to maintain this capital in the new profit ratio. Okay, so we'll transfer this, the difference, into the cash. So see, now when you deduct this side, credit side, from this amount, so minus 20,000, minus 2,000, minus 5,200. Okay, what is the difference? So 10,675. So here we will write down 10,675, that is by cash account. Clear? Your cash is there. Okay? So here in cash account, what you'll write down? So 2L's capital account. So see, 2L's capital account, that is 10,675. Clear? Then see, for the next partner we will do, see again, year 22. And 6, so 28, 29, 30, 31, round about more than 30,000, and here the amount is less. So again we can understand that this side is only greater, so we'll do the total of this side. So 6,000 plus 3,200 plus 22,325, what you are getting? 31,525. Clear? Same total we will write down here, 31,525. Now deduct this side, minus 12,500, minus 2,000, minus 5,200. The difference is coming, that is 11,825. So that we will write down here, 11,825. See, this is now the answer, that is in cash. The partner has to bring this much to maintain this capital. Okay, so here it is by cash for B. So here there will be 2B's capital account, that is 11,825. Now we will close our cash and bank. So see, 11,825 already there on the screen. So plus 10,675 and plus 2,000. So it is 24,500. This side also I'll write down 24,500. This side I have to deduct, that is 22,500. So minus 22,500. Clear? So 2000. See why the opening and closing is same? Because this amount was the difference. Okay, this much they have to give. See, this amount 22,500. So that same extra amount will come here. Okay, and this has been gone. So again, the same will be closing. That is by balance carried down. Clear? They have told in the last adjustment that whatever the W is taking in cash is to be brought by L and B. Okay. to they will be giving to W. So this is the difference. So this difference is only coming year. If you add this two, you will get this amount only. That is 22,500. Clear? Then this is your closing cash balance. So this will go your cash. That is 2,000. Now we will do the total. Here it is 47. First we'll do the asset side. 50,000 plus 5,000 plus 13,000 plus 2,000. So it is coming, that is 70,000. Same we will write down here, 70,000. Now we will deduct one by one, minus 47,000, minus 20,000, minus 3,000. So it is coming zero, it means the balance sheet has been tallied. Okay, so this is your the solution for question number 30.